Today's a sad video for everyone in the music industry. Little Richard sadly passed away. Hey everyone, what's up? My name's Ryder Bard. You can call me Kyle. As you heard in the intro, Little Richard passed away at age 87 on Saturday. According to his lawyer, the death was from bone cancer. 2020 just seems to be going from worse to somehow even more worse. We've lost incredibly talented people like Tony Allen. We've been through horrendous bushfires and floods. We thought we were going to be in the middle of a World War III at the beginning of the year. We're now in the middle of a pandemic. And as of Saturday, we lost Little Richard. Today's video will be short, but I just wanted to speak on Little Richard and why I believe he's so talented and why his legacy will live on forever. As a massive fan of all genres of music, for more decades, and as a music journalist myself, I really felt I was obligated to make this video, but more importantly, I knew I had to make this video. So let's start with the why, as in why Little Richard's impact on music is so impactful. Little Richard is credited as one of the founding fathers of rock and roll, who captured the stage presence and the showmanship that we see even to this day. When we think of incredible stage presence, we often think of stars like Freddie Mercury or Prince, who could control stadiums, who weren't afraid of facing social norms head on and disregarding them. Stars that will never be matched due to the time periods in which they existed, and the societal experiences and expectations in which surrounded them. One of my favorite quotes was said by Little Richard in 1989.
When I see Prince today, you know, Prince is Little Richard in this generation. Don't get mad about that, Prince. I looked just as good as you look today. I was wearing purple before you was wearing it. Shut up.
This quote really, really captures the impact of Little Richard. He was one of the founding fathers of rock and roll, who influenced stars like Freddie Mercury and Prince, who without Little Richard, we might not have seen rock and roll popularized by stars like Elvis Presley later on. And I really mean that. I think it's important to look at the beginning of Little Richard so we can further appreciate and understand the journey that the legend undertook and the trials that he overcame. I personally also like looking at the beginning of stars so that I can put things in perspective, and as a creative myself, it gives me motivation, it gives me a strong drive to do better, to achieve more. Little Richard was actually one of 12 children, which surprised me. He grew up poor, and according to an interview with Rolling Stone in 1970, his dad sold bootleg whiskey just to get by. His dad sang at church, but wasn't supportive of Little Richard's music, and he actually had accused Little Richard of being gay. So that support network wasn't there. At age 13, Little Richard moved out and moved in with another family in Macon. I think that's how you say it. I was actually really surprised at this part. Little Richard's childhood best friend was Otis Redding, an incredibly talented musician, and is actually regarded as one of the greatest singers in American history. Now, this is probably one of my favorite parts of the whole story. Working at a concession stand in Macon City Auditorium was where Little Richard for the first time, and I emphasize for the first time, heard R&B, blues music, and country music. I think that's so incredible that this amazing star who changed music history forever didn't actually hear R&B, blues music, and country music till he was working at a concession stand. It just blows my mind, and it shows that it's never too early to follow your dream, which Little Richard definitely did, and you can see his legacy is so big that I don't think it will ever be matched. No one can ever match or surpass what Little Richard had accomplished. Little Richard then performed at the TikTok Club, and no, not as in the app, and this is a really cool part. After winning a local talent show, Little Richard was signed by RCA Records in 1951. So this was the start of Little Richard's great career. So now that we've looked at Little Richard's start, his beginning, we can further appreciate the journey that he undertook and the trials that he overcame to be where he is regarded today. Little Richard is one of the greatest and most talented musicians of all time, and without his sacrifices and his total rejection of societal expectations and norms, he wouldn't have broken through as many musical barriers as he did and opened as many doorways as he has for the musicians that came after him. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll be doing more videos like this in the future where I analyze musicians' legacies and give my thoughts. Although today's video was a sad one, I'm looking at Little Richard's history and his impact in a positive light. He made many people happy with his music and his beautiful personality. So if you're still watching to this point, please take a moment to appreciate the impact that Little Richard's music has had on you and music in general. My name's Ryder Bard, you can call me Kyle, and peace. We'll be right back.